Welcome to the Florida Chamber's Bottom Line, where this week we spotlight Senate President Mike Haradopoulos with perspective from Florida Chamber President Mark Wilson. 3 weeks into the 2011 session, Mr. President, the only thing you really have to do is balance a budget. How's that going to work, cutting $3 to $4 billion?
It will be a difficult task, but it's required. First and foremost, we will not raise taxes or fees to make up the gap. We're going to spend less, but they come from three vital areas: healthcare, education, and pension and benefits for state workers.
And can you do that without cutting into essential services?
It's going to be a tough one, but we're going to do our best. We're going to go to, the essential services, try to fund those, and then make do. But it's a tough job, but nothing unlike businesses and families are going through right now.
Or related to that, you have championed the so-called smart cap, a constitutional amendment for next year's ballot. What will it do, and why is it a good thing?
Well, it's a very common sense idea, making sure that we don't overspend when times are good so we don't have difficulties like we're in today. I call the Old Testament option. Joseph talked about it. When times are good, don't eat all your corn. So when times are bad, you don't have to eat sand. It's a common sense proposal that limits spending, you put the extras in reserves, and you draw on those reserves when times go bad or in tough times like today. And at a certain point, once you reach 10% of the reserves, you actually automatically trigger tax cuts. So you're constantly feeding the free market as opposed to feeding government.
Well, the first bill out of the session going to the governor is the so-called teacher tenure bill. It's consistent with education reforms Republicans have promoted. What will it actually do?
Well, first and foremost, it was, I think, a very impressive process. Every bill went through three committees in the Florida Senate. We had workshops. Everyone had a voice. Steve Wise spent the summer, fall, winter, and now spring listening to people before coming up with a bill. It was a bill that passed through three committees, received bipartisan support, and it passed, again, the second week of session. The governor will sign into law. What it will do with two things. One is reform tenure. No one can have a guaranteed job anymore. And second, let's reward the best teachers with higher pay. It's a common sense idea that has finally come, and we're proud to pass it out this early in the session.
And what's the Florida Chamber's perspective on this kind of reform?
Well, education is a top priority in Florida. And so putting teachers first and putting kids first is a critical, important issue for the state of Florida. We appreciate the legislature for making that their number one bill.
And the critics say it's not going to be a good reform?
Well,
How are they right or wrong?
Well, they're not right. If you look at the long term, we need to pay great teachers great salaries. And that's what we're trying to do in Florida.
Mr. President, the legislature is moving toward a defined contribution for state employees' retirements as opposed to the defined benefit. What will that mean for state employees?
Well, just a reflection of what's already happened in the private sector. Again, government needs to learn from the private sector. This is a great example. We can't afford defined benefit programs anymore. They're a dinosaur we can't afford to feed. And so we're going to choose to do is look to the private sector. They've already moved to a 401k or an IRA, whatever you want to call it. And more importantly, is about freedom, because you can take that with you. You're not kind of locked into a job for a long period of time. And also the realities of demographics. My dad will be 80 years old this year, was in a defined benefit program. That's the idea. We get 11 workers for every one retiree. When I turn 80, there'll be two workers for one retiree. We're just reflecting the logical business climate that exists today.
And Mark Wilson, does the Florida Chamber support that move to have the public sector retirement mirror the private sector?
Oh, of course we do. What we have right now is unfair and unsustainable. And we want to protect teachers and firefighters and police's pension. And the best way to do that is to make this more fair and have them participate in the process.
Well, finally, Mr. President, you have championed also a 2012 constitutional amendment about the federal health care reform that would allow Florida to opt out. Can Florida legally opt out with a positive vote on this?
Well, I think, first of all, it's the one section we're going to opt out of. That's the mandate. It's a mandate. It's a bad idea. It never works. And what you're saying is if you can't afford insurance, you got to pay a $400 fine. That's ridiculous. We want to have a one-on-one relationship with their doctor. They want to make it work so we're successful. But this is in the hands of the voters, 60% in the fall of 2012. We're confident we'll get there. But let's all reflect the what now is known as Obamacare is unsustainable. It will increase our Medicaid rolls by almost 50%. This is a time we're already struggling with a very difficult budget.
Mark Wilson, the Chamber has been actively involved in reforming the constitutional amendment process in Florida. Can this particular proposal get the 60% approval it needs?
Oh, of course it can. Voters of Florida are smart, and I think they know what this Obamacare is all about. I think they're looking for the opportunity to make this right.
Finally, Senator Haradopoulos, what's the heaviest lift you and your peers in the legislature have to accomplish? What do you need to shoulder most this session?
Well, it goes back to your first question, Ron, balancing the budget without raising taxes and fees. As you know, the budget deficit has actually grown by almost $200 million. We're at now $3.8 $1 billion shortfall. That means, as you talked about earlier, those vital services, education and healthcare specifically, very difficult to make those choices. But that's why we're up here. We need to make the tough calls in these difficult times so that Florida can prosper and grow once again in the future.
Mark Wilson, if the Florida Chamber had to give a three-week report card, how are we doing in this session?
Well, the bottom line on this session is, so far, the courage and leadership we've seen is right in line with what the business community was hoping for. And so what we want to do is continue to see our legislature put the long-term interests of Florida ahead of the short-term interests of the special interests that just don't want to move forward.
All right. Florida Chamber President Mark Wilson, Senate President Mike Haradopoulos, thank you both. We hope your bottom line is looking up.